an attractive 23-year-old woman. She loves her adoptive parents dearly, but was always curious about her birth parents. Hall's adoptive mother encouraged her to join ALMA, and it was the group's help and Hall's ingenuity that led her to this anxious but happy wait at Metro Airport. Within moments, she would set eyes on her birth father for the first time. Hall and her French-Canadian parent were understandably nervous.
I'm still a bit nervous about it. Like, I sort of feel out of place in a way, really, you know, like... There's so much difference between her and I in color, like, more or less. It's really hard to believe, like, she's really my daughter.
Okay.
But her mother, she does look, there's similarities in, like, her forehead and different features of her mother. And same with the eyes. The eyes are the same as the mother.
How do you feel, Monica?
Well, it was hard at first. It wasn't hard. It was just a little, what do you say type thing. But, well, I'd asked him so many questions, you know, like, what do your toes look like? Let me see your ears. I have your lips. Do you like Fig Newtons? You know, silly things. Do you like to fish? No, I don't like them, neither do I, you know.
How do you feel about it?
I feel quite happy about it, yes. I'm quite happy to have met my daughter, yes, which I've often wondered about within the last few years, what she did look like.
We're pleased with what I found.
As most ALMA members, Monica kept a notebook of her search and enjoyed sharing it with her birth father and his wife. She and Harvey are anxious to keep in touch, and Monica's looking forward to meeting her half-brothers and sisters, and they her. Monica contacted her birth mother's family in Canada first, but sadly learned her natural mother had died 11 years ago.